It's Friday the 22nd of December 2017 and we are pleased to bring you today's edition of Local News. Welcome. In the news, children with disabilities celebrate Christmas. Union at Medis Ascending presented petition to the Speaker of Parliament. Opinions on land taxes differs in Parliament. Power company ABS to be screened. I am Randy Kromo Di Harjo and your local news begins now. Children of the Matuku Foundation receive a special Christmas celebration from Regilio Maknak, a Dutch artist known as Makkie. While the children waited for Regilio Maknak, they enjoyed lots of Christmas loaf, pastries and drinks. The children also had their own performance. It has always been his dream to perform for children with disabilities, says Regilio. The children were all allowed to go on stage to perform together with the artist for the invited guest. After the official part, they listened to all the songs on the CD of Regilio Maknak. The children showed their best dance steps and went on the photo with Regilio. The union at the Medis Ascending presented a petition yesterday to the National Assembly. Speaker of Parliament Jennifer Geerling-Simons accepted this petition. The petition states that the transfer of the promised salary payment to the Medis Ascending should be transferred yesterday. The receipts for the payment had already been signed, says Chairman of the Union at the Medis Ascending, Roy Haverkamp. The opinions between the coalition and the opposition are divided over the increase of land taxes. The increase of land taxes, the sale of state shares and state property are some of the government's options. The increase of land taxes, the sale of state shares and state property are some of the government's options to increase state revenue. On behalf of the VHP party, Mahinder Jogi asked the government to abandon this increase. On the other hand, the government has enough support from the NDP party to continue with the policy to increase land taxes. Silvana Afonsoa expressed the opinion of the NDP. The budget debate has again been postponed to give the government time to make all the changes that need to be made to the budget. Amidst reports about the screening of the power company ABS, the director of the company, Rabinder Parmisser, says that the necessary labor rest should not be overlooked. It is necessary to keep the company together in good consultation healthy. Rabinder Parmisser at the same time looks back on the year 2017. The year 2018 will be a dynamic year for the ABS. There are gigantic projects planned. The basis for this has been laid this year. In addition to these large-scale projects, an information fair will be launched in January 2018. At this fair, society will be informed about protocols at alternative energy generation. As for now, this is your local news for today. But before ending this edition, we'd like to wish you all a Merry Christmas. Till next week, Wednesday.